Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. We just had Circuit Court Judge Gregory Bill on, and he painted a pretty grim picture of what's really going on out there in Wayne County. He's in the criminal division. But now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to introduce you to a friend of mine, Linda Bernard. She's running for 36th District Court Judge, and Linda's a little bit special to me. Many of you have had the circumstance when you're overqualified to do a job. Well, I had that circumstance when I left my father's corporations back in the early 90s. It was very hard to get a job. And I actually found a job at Neighborhood Legal Services where I met Linda Bernard. She hired me. I did data analysis and all sorts of stuff for her back then. And now she's running for judge. You know, I want to thank you. You know, you introduced me to Marion Barry. You know so many people. Tell us about the length of your career, man. You've been doing law forever.
Well, I started as a lawyer with Ford Motor Company as their third African-American staff attorney. Mm-hmm. And then I was recruited to go on loan to the city of Detroit by Mayor Coleman Young. So I was Mayor Young's youngest managing attorney. I created the contracts and business division for the city of Detroit. All of the contracts that you sign today and execute today are based on templates for all 66 departments that I created. Wow. I did that for the city, and I also wrote the procurement code. So then I went to Boston to be general counsel for the Massachusetts Port Authority, mm-hmm. but came back to Detroit because my father was ill, to be head of Neighborhood Legal Services. And then shortly after that, of course, we met. Mm-hmm. And I'm very proud of what we did at Neighborhood Legal Services.
Oh, we really did it. That AIDS Day and all that stuff.
Yeah, we had. As a matter of fact, I was crying at my kitchen table last night because Philadelphia was on. And I had forgotten how hard it was for me to create the AIDS Law Center and how people had the lesions and all that. And how I got that program, how I got funding for that from Ryan White. And so I could accept individuals that had that disease and provide them with high quality legal services and their families, because there are will issues, discrimination issues, all kinds of issues. And it made me cry sitting there last night watching it. But we did the Children's Law Center, of course, an Arabic Law Center, Hispanic Law Center, the Disability Law Center in conjunction with Wayne State University Law School. Mm-hmm. Just a number of centers. And one program that I was particularly proud of, and that you helped me with, quite frankly, was our COPS program for African-American men who were ex-offenders. We hired them as paralegals in our program. And you helped me with that and helped me get funding for that, along with our Children's Law Center. You were active in both of those, and of course, street law, which, you know, was phenomenally successful within the Detroit public school system.
Now, with that response, this next question seems rather ludicrous. What makes you think you're qualified to be a 36th District Court judge?
That's a good question. Well, I've argued and won three cases in the Michigan Supreme Court. For me, those are a little like gold medals. I mean, just getting to the Supreme Court, because they only accept about 150 cases a year, is mm-hmm. like getting to the Olympics. And then if you win, then that's the gold medal. So I got there and I won. All three times I went, and all in precedent-setting labor mm-hmm. cases, quite frankly. So I'm very proud of that. Secondly, I'm an expert with respect to dealing with management issues. I can manage a courtroom. I can do things differently. I can, of course, and will treat people from Detroit who are anyone who's actually in our courtroom with dignity and respect, a dignity and respect that they seldom see or get.
Well, with all that being said, you know, Supreme Court, managing a courtroom, only one question left about it. Can you get to work on time? One of the major complaints from my friends and my people in Detroit is that 36th District Court doesn't start on time.
Well, let me say this to you. I'm licensed in Michigan, Massachusetts, Pennsylvania, the District of Columbia, the U.S. Supreme Court, the U.S. International Court of Trade, the U.S. Court of Claims, Federal District Court in Michigan and in Philadelphia, and of course the Sixth Circuit Court of Appeals. Not only do I know how to get to court on time and be on time, I will not be on time, Steve. I will be early, because if I'm on time, then I'm late when you walk in the door. If you and I walk in the door at the same time, then I'm late. I'm supposed to be at my desk and ready to work when you come through that door, and that's precisely where I will be. You will have a professional staff. You won't have people hollering at you and telling you what to do and treating you like you're subhuman. I can promise you that. You will hear about my courtroom. I guarantee it.
Okay. Well, Linda Bernard, let's hope it's Judge Bernard next time we talk to you. We've got to go to break. When we come back, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to get up and enjoy Detroit. How in the world do you say all that and not be out of breath? We'll be right back.